Hi everyone, I'm Ibrahim Ulukaya from YouTube API Developer Relations team, joining you from New York. And today we'll talk about Resumable Uploads. Resumable Uploads is an uploading protocol for Google APIs. It lets you upload files and save time and bandwidth if your file was uploading, there's a transmission error or that there was a network error. It's essentially useful if you are transferring large files, or if you are in an unreliable network, or you are using a device with a low bandwidth, such as a mobile device. This protocol is already implemented in Google libraries, but as well as you can use the normal JSON request as long as you know the drill. So let's go to my laptop and see it a little. If you try to use the JSON, to go over this design diagram, you will first initiate a request. You will just first send a post metadata and the content type you want to send. So if you are inserting a video, you will say that you will actually send the video metadata and the content type is the video. Once your client actually sends to the server this request, if the request is successful, the server will return back with a 200 response with the location of your upload. So it will tell you the location that your upload will happen. Using this location, then you can actually start sending uploads either in chunks, or you can upload in only one, in one request, in one chunk, and you can actually send all your content. If you decide to go on in chunks, you will actually keep receiving like 308 requests that you actually still have more chunks to go. Your chunk was successful, and then if you only upload like one chunk, or if you have like many chunks but you're uploading the final chunk, once that chunk is uploaded as well, you will actually receive a 200 successful response. With this, you understand your upload is successful. And the other way is, if your upload was not successful, we'll also cover that point as well. So let's go over to our developer pages, developer.google.com/YouTube. And there is a guide over there using Resumable uploads. And let's see examples from there. So here's an example that you actually started like a post request. Here's the URL for the post request. HTTPS Google API upload YouTube v3/video, and you actually say upload type is Resumable. You set its content length as video's content length, and its X upload content type as video type, and you have the video metadata. And if the session was successful, they will send it you with the location. And using this location, you are actually sending a put request from there on and putting your binary file data. If it's one chunk, then you put it all like this. Or if you want to go actually with chunking into like smaller chunks, then you can actually give us like content range and say that you are actually sending that range of the bytes, and you are actually sending that bytes only. So if everything was successful, as we mentioned, you're actually returning a 200 request. If actually your upload was not successful, but it can be still resumed, you may actually, your network could be like down, or you may have actually received one of the error responses. It could be one of the 500 responses, could be like 500, internal server error, bad gateway, service unavailable, or gateway timeout. But if your response was like somehow like one of the 400 responses or any other 500 responses we didn't mention here, then your upload could be failed. The only way to check it is actually you are sending another upload put request, but this time setting its length to zero and content range is like byte *, so that the content length, that this way you actually understand that you are trying to like check the set for upload, not trying to upload more file. In the response, you will actually get, just as like any other chunk upload responses, you'll get the range and you'll understand to that point which part of the file was uploaded already. But it may actually return as like a 404 response. That means that your session ID was already expired. So by this way, we really suggest you that once you start the initiation request, keep sending the upload chunks right after that. We already checked in the, this was the JSON, and if you want to actually use the just the libraries, it's almost available in, you know, in you know, for client libraries. And here's like a small diagram to explain it in the Resumable media upload in the Java one. That media HTTP uploader will actually do the whole process for you. You'll only start the upload, and media HTTP uploader will take from there. It will send the HTTP request. If it fails, it will actually back off from there and it will try again. So let's see it on one of our examples. And here is in our github.com/YouTube where all our open source examples are. So we created media content with using the our video file. Then we want to create an insert request. And in the insert request, we put the metadata as well as the media content we just get, or video file. Instead of just executing this, we use the media HTTP uploader, which is the object that handles Resumable uploads for us, or the uploads for us in general. So we get that uploader, and to make it Resumable, we set it direct upload enabled to false, which means you will use the Resumable uploads. And once you execute, it will, the media uploader will take over and do the Resumable uploads. You can even implement a progress listener with a media HTTP upload progress listener object and keep track of the progress. You can even from, if you dig that from there, you will be able to see the, you can actually get the percentage of your upload and you can show it in your app. And that's all I want to cover today. We just go over to the how to upload the Resumable upload through either from JSON or through one of you using one of our client libraries. And as I always want to plug, as developer relations team, either in YouTube or in other departments, we are hiring almost everywhere in the world. You can always check it from developers.google.com/jobs. And this is Ibrahim Ulukaya from New York.